Now, if you're having a problem with your iPhone, one of the first things that you'll want to do is check your storage, particularly if you do not have a lot of storage on your iPhone. Any computer, and your iPhone is just a computer, any computer likes to have about 10 to 20% of free space. And when you get below that, if your iPhone gets below that, it could cause random issues. That's what we're going to look at in this video, how we can manage our storage on the iPhone. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at managing storage on the iPhone. Now, if you're having issues with your iPhone, I should rephrase that, if you're having random issues on your iPhone, one of the first things you want to do is check the storage on your iPhone. Why do I say random? Well, basically, when you're running low on space on any type of computer, including your iPhone, it can cause different types of issues. There's not any certain one type of issue that happens. So if you're having random issues across multiple apps, one of the first things you'll want to do is check the storage. So where can we do that? Well, basically, we do this through our Settings app. So I tap on Settings. And then from here, what we do is we go over to General. Under General, what you're going to see is iPhone storage. So that's where we need to go. And when we go here, we go up to the top, you're going to see it tells us how much storage I'm using as well as how much I have. So I am using 42 gigabytes out of 512 gigabytes. I'm not using a lot of space. But if this was getting close, like I say, if it's under 10%, so let's just say that you are using 475 gigabytes out of 512. Well, that tells me that you may be having issues due to low storage. So what can you do? Well, basically, you just need to clear the iPhone. You need to free up more space. So there are different ways to do that. You're going to see that Apple does have different recommendations, so I can review large attachments there in Mail or in Messages and remove them. They are being stored on my iPhone. Well, when I tap on this, what I'm able to do is delete some of these from the iPhone. And then that'll free up space. So I just swipe to the left and we can delete it. So that's one way of freeing up space. Just follow these recommendations. And you may have different recommendations. This is what it's telling me because I have a lot of attachments here. Another thing that I can do is I can optimize storage. With optimized storage, this will automatically remove maps that I'm not using. With the Maps app with iOS 18, we can download maps for offline viewing. Those can take up quite a bit of space. Well, if you optimize the storage, what you're able to do is have the iPhone automatically remove those to free up space. Another thing is we can go and see what apps are using our storage. So we can see that my music app here is using the most storage. It's sorted by size. And then our next one here is ConSim 2. I don't play that game. I'd like to get rid of it. Well, then you just tap on it, and then we can delete that app. When we delete the app, it's going to delete the data and the app. Now, let's say you wanted to just delete the app and not the data. Maybe you're not playing the game right now, but you want to come back to it. And you want to come back to the same place that you were. Well, then what you do is you offload the app. It'll still remove the app, which will free up some space, but it's not going to remove any data that the app is using. So in this case here, the app size is 2 gigabytes, so we'll free up 2 gigabytes, but it'll still keep 12 kilobytes on my iPhone. That is if I use offload app. If I delete the app, it'll just remove everything. When you offload an app, the app icon will still be on your iPhone here, but it's going to have a little cloud next to it. You just tap on it, it'll download that app, and then you can resume where you were. So we just go into our Settings app. And then we go to our iPhone storage, and we can just go through and delete the apps or offload the ones that we no longer need. Now, if you want to sort by when they were last used, you can do that as well. I have size up here. That's the default sorting. I tap on it, and I can sort by last use date. So with this little trick, I can actually see apps that I haven't used. I just go down to the bottom here, and these are the apps that I haven't used in a while. So now what I'm able to do is delete these. I can just tap on any one of them. So let's go to DualGram, and I can go and delete that app. So in addition to sorting by size, we can also sort by when they were last used, as well as name. Now, some apps will actually go and allow us to delete the data individually. Let's go back. I'm going to tap on back here. And now I'm going to go and take a look at music. When I look at music, what I'm able to do is not only offload the app as well as delete the app, but I can also see what music is taking up all of my space. And then from here, I'm able to delete it. So I can tap on Bruno Mars and tap on it again. And then if I go up to edit here, I'm able to, these are all the songs that are on my iPhone. I tap on edit and I can remove those songs individually. I can also, let's go back. I can also tap on edit here and remove that entire album, and it'll remove all the songs. So some apps will actually allow us to go in there and delete the data that is in the app. So that's how we manage our storage on the iPhone. And you really only need to do this when you're running into random problems. Just go into the iPhone storage and see what has taken up all the space. And then from there, you're able to follow Apple's recommendations and remove different items. Or you can go and remove them yourself. You just go into the Settings app, go to General, and then go over to iPhone storage. So that's how we manage our storage on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can share it with your friends and family. You can also subscribe to my channel. In addition to that, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. Not only do I have more videos, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius, and I have or host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, it is a membership-based site. So when you become a member, you give access to that AI assistant, modeled after an Apple genius. You have access to my classes and webinars, and I take out all of the videos or all of the ads on the videos. I don't take out all of the videos. I take off the ads from the videos, so you're not going to see any of those pesky ads. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. I'm not part of some large organization, so when you become a member, you're directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out Dan's tutorials for more information, and thanks for watching.